Okay, this is the another just mega foundations. I'm starting the case study in filed the left foundations. There are so many just case studies already done in the filed left foundations here. So I'm just mention about here, and then you can go into the in detail in the next lecture. In 1990, there are so many just case studies performed on these pile draft foundations in the European country, and this is one of the example cases over here. And you can just think about the just left load over here. So the pile draft means there are two portions of the loading. Is sustained by one is the raft and the another is the pile foundation, and this portion about this amount of portion will be carried by the raft. Okay, so that's the case mentioned in the early stages, and then so many packages over here on the pile raft foundation case studies. So I cannot going in detail, this is the cases. Another one cases is done by many other many other just scholars. They are working on the pile draft case stories, and you can just report to my just lecture over here. Also in Japan, also they are using pile draft foundations, especially is done by the case study by these just scholars over here. In Korea also, we are doing some pile draft foundations in this area. As I told you, it's Jamsil Super Towers, and this is the information we are looking on the designing stages and some construction stages and some foundation design stages by the manufacturers over there. And I'm just showing the case study over here. This is the plan view, and this is the section view of this just Jamsil Super Tower. And there are some analyzing the result done by just our research group, and for these just towers, and we can predict using some kind of some analysis result with other just case studies. This is only the emphasizing only done. This is the cases of that site, and then by using some our just predictions and some other predictions in the field, and we can compare the result of the pile draft foundations of this case study, Korean style cases for the different site, and we can just predict, and we can compare the prediction result and the observed ones in this graph. So this afternoon, you have a chance to have this kind of some exercise using this kind of predictions done by this blue. This is the, looks like the measurement over there, and then our predictions like over there is one is the linear and nonlinear analysis, and we can capture the behavior of the some kind of distance between from here to here. So about 80 just meter, and there is some kind of differential settlement between this front side and the back side over here. There is some faulting zones over there. Another case is my university also constructing another some 10 story buildings on campus, and I chose one just test piles over here in the corner, and we have five different piles, and we can instrument it field instrumentations based on something like the attaching the strain gauges in the back and front, and some other stops is some of the steps is pressure gauges, earth pressure, and so strain gauges along the pile. And due to the construction stages of the superstructures, as time goes on, there is an increase of the first floor, second floor, third floor, and the 10th story building, and then you can check the settlement of underneath the loft by something like that, settlement over here, and there is a loading increment up to 10 story buildings, and depending on the location of the piles, the test piles at different locations, we can predict the measured and the prediction ones at different locations, the corner pile and the center piles over there. So the loading applied on top of the just pile foundation, there is resisted by one is the loft, one is the just the pile itself, and we can compare the result with here. And this is the result, just the comparison result. This just all dotted line is a prediction, and the real just solid line means there is some measurement by the field instrumentation. And this is the result of the measured and prediction result. Maybe this is another cases, but I'm just talking. The cases, we are so many cases in the Bidraft Foundation. So I'm showing more Korean case, but the other countries, they are doing their own just testings over there. In the construction site, especially the Korean, just they have their own some case histories. In the one is the Busan cases, and that's the plan view, and there is a section view. So in the designing just process, most of the piling is bearing into this some sedimentary sand layer for this kind of some medium story buildings. And this is the real cases we performed some Bidraft foundations in this area. And another section, and the piling, and loft, and some kind of some buildings over there. But most of the piling is not going into the rock bases. We are doing some bearing into a certain soil layer. Why? Most of the sump part is resisted by the loft. That's why the piling, the embedment can be reduced due to the partial supporting by this loft. The properties used in the designing process, and we check the first with the piling, your mat foundation with the piling, and then we check the all kind of some stresses and settlement over there based on the allowable settlement. In case of some mat foundation, it's not satisfied the soil settlement. That's why if we use the pile loft, we can just satisfy this kind of settlement criteria. This is the case. It's Busan, the southern part of the Korean peninsula. This kind of some high-rise apartment complex, we can use some Bidraft foundations. This is the site and the analysis based on numerically, and this is the result of the just analysis. Also, Japan is one of the countries they are using the Bidraft, and some kind of some testings at these early stages, and some kind of properties they used, and some kind of calculation, and then they are using the result and the comparison result based on their testings over there. Another case is Bidraft Foundation, some simulation, and then this is the result of the cases they are proposing. Japan case, German cases, maybe you know well about these buildings. Many textbooks are talking about the buildings by this guy and his five draft foundations. And then studying properties and compare each method. Predict well the general trend of that test site. The result, comparison result by German cases. This is the deal, just constructions by just Neckel Tower is at the end of some designing stages, I told you, 1.4 kilometer. This is the located in Frankfurt, in the main site. We call this main tower in the downtown. Designed by Draft Foundation. Also another bank, European bank, is the same area. It's one of the example case of the file Draft Foundations. For the main tower, initially, they just designed using file foundations, this amount of files, and then this amount of money. And the changing to the combined file draft foundation, reduced to the file, just number of files, and then they can get this kind of construction fee. And only filing is expensive than the file draft foundation, up to $4 million. I mean, this is the comparison of the result of the filing and the file draft foundations. The same as the bank, also about $9.2 million is cheaper using the file draft foundations. It's not my conclusion. You know that Dr. Kajembao is a well-known scholar in this field. He is near the Frankfurt, and he's measuring and this kind of some cost-effective result based on the file draft foundations. Another museum, Frankfurt, also they are cost-effective result on this the cost. City Tower, Germany, same as the result, some cheaper result using the file draft foundation. There are so many just case stories done in Germany and any other countries. And this is the case study I'm just showing. That's why you know what's going on these file draft foundations. And I'd like to start. What's the file draft foundation? As you can see in the previous lecture, I'm just cite from some buildings in Frankfurt. As I told you, this building, main tower, the bank building, they are talking about. First, I'm just checking. What's the bearing layer of these buildings? Already these buildings. So this is the thick delta Frankfurt clay over there. And the bearing up to this range. Also main tower, about 60 stories building, is still located on this area over here. How about the bank? It looks like Frankfurt limestone is the bearing to support this building. So I am just focusing on these two buildings still there. They are all staying on this soil layer, especially they call the Frankfurt clay. So we have some idea how to handle this kind of some foundations here. That's a pile draft foundation. Pile draft foundation and he's talking about Kajembao. He's talking about some kind of this kind of some pile draft foundation here. I am the second the vice president of this just committee, and Dr. Asishi's just colleague, Dr. Dipanka, is in the professor of this university. At the time, he was the secretary of this just committee, and we are working for the combined pile draft foundation, combined C PRF Foundation, Combined Philanthropy Foundation, working for this, and why we are nearly want to use the Philanthropy Foundation? Because in most case here, for this just the museum building, they using the designing, the settlement calculation is about 40 centimeter, greater than 40 centimeter in the designing stages. And he nearly want to reduce the settlement. And most of the settlement come from the shallow depths over here, up to 20 meter. About 80% of settlement come from in this area. So they nearly want to reduce the settlement using Philanthropy Foundation. And they nearly want to see the settlement consideration. Below the building, there is some stress increment from top to down, like this, just the trend. And then this soil modulus is greater as deeper and deeper, like here. So settlement is just like this kind of simple equations in most cases, is greater in the rest. And this portion, the shallow depths, we can expect a higher settlement based on this kind of some simple explanations. We know that. That's why we want to use the combined Philanthropy Foundations. Right? Initially, we expect about 40 centimeters of foundation settlement on the shallow depths, about 80% of that. So this kind of problem is based on this kind of simple theory and result. And then if you use the Philanthropy, maybe you can use, we can just reduce the settlement of it in this area. So this is the one of the example case for the bridge, just the pier foundation. One is the typical just pile foundations. Another one is the typical shallow foundations. At this area, in between, there is some bearing shorter depths. And then for the pile foundations over here, the road settlement curve is looks like here. For this, just number one, three, option three. And then the spread is a shallow foundation, has this kind of some behavior, road settlement behavior. So it's a certain just resistance is higher settlement we observed in this just shallow foundation compared to this rigid and bearing pile foundations in between. Here, if we just use this kind of Philanthropy Foundations, maybe we can make just kind of behavior in between. So as a designer, we can think about settlement-based design based on here. Even we have a little lower resistance, but still we can control the settlement using this kind of analysis result in this area at the time. So in this just lecture, we nearly want to understand the meaning of the Philanthropy Foundation and would you like to find out the analysis and so on. In one word, I can say the most of the previous conventional foundation and designing is a capacity-based design. So we nearly want to move into another stage is settlement-based design analysis. So to ensure capacity of a foundation, we need a large diameter and bearing pile. However, if you can move into this direction, we can ensure serviceability of the superstructure, and we need a small diameter friction piles instead of end bearing piles. So the design concept of pile foundation, here there is a load acting on the top of the is here, and then and transmitted this loading resisted by the pile plus wrapped, pile plus emitting wrapped is resisting the applied loading. So the total resistance is the, like a pile plus wrapped, and the pile is only the end bearing plus skin friction. It's a typical one. Also, we need the wrapped portion is resisted by in between. There is a wrapped resistance over here. It's simple. The applied loading can be resisted by pile and wrapped. That's it. And in this situation, we can consider the interactions because it's a little complicated. That's why we need this kind of interaction problems. Soil, pile, soil, pile, wrapped interactions. There are so many interactions involved in these cases. So I'd like to define. One is the pile wrapped coefficient. Somebody told me it's a load sharing ratio of pile wrapped foundation. That means the total resistance of pile wrapped and then pile, just the resistance. So that means the portion of the pile over the total resistance by pile and wrapped. That's why here the interaction, and then that means this kind of shallow one, zero, right? How about the pile foundations? That's this coefficient is about one. In between is from zero to one, right? So in this graph, I can say fully pile foundation is coefficient is one. How about the shallow unpiled raft has zero values, okay? So in between, you can expect the pile raft foundations. Load sharing ratio is like that, defined the resistance by pile over the total resistance. That means the is starting from 0 to 1 over here. This just the factor, coefficient alpha pi, highly depends on many influence factors. So many factors involved to influence this kind of alpha pi. Different soil type, different pile dimension, number of piles, pile arrangement, and different loading types and the soil structure interaction. So yesterday, just Dr. Ashish's students are talking about some centrifuge testings. They are doing so many different cases like different soil type, different number of just piles, pile arrangement, and any kind of things just based on experimental testings to identify the influence factors for alpha PR. So I'd like to just summarizing advantages of this just pile wrapped foundation. It's a significant reduction in number of lengths of piles. You can reduce the length. And then improvement of the serviceability of shallow foundations. By adding the pile, you can increase the serviceability of the shallow just foundations. Also, there is a reduction in the internal stresses and the bending moments. And that's why we can improve the bearing capacity of a shallow foundation using pile wrapped foundations. Reduction of the heave and outside what looks like this kind of excavation work. Also, there is one eccentric loading cases, but still this reduction in the number of lengths, increase of serviceability, and improve of the bearing capacity of a shallow foundation using pile wrapped foundations. This is the advantages of pile wrapped foundations, just I can summarize it here. Also, what's the favorable condition for this pile wrapped foundation is relatively steep clay. to resist the by left foundations underneath the left, we need more relatively stiff clay or relatively dense sand instead of soft clay, loose sand. Consolidation take place, some compressible layer, swelling condition is not good condition. Only we can just have this kind of relatively stiff or dense soil condition, maybe we can have pile drop foundations. I mean, so in the design consideration, and same as the pile foundation, still we need to consider the first ultimate geotechnical capacity on the various loadings, like vertical, horizontal, and bending moment loading. And then we can calculate the overall settlement and the stiffness value, and also checking the differential settlement, and some kind of lateral movement, and finally the structural design of both loft and piles, maybe. We need to consider in the designing stages of pile loft, and then you can have some kind of some optimal design of these just foundations. So maybe the same just the equation I'm showing, the total is loft portion and the pile portion. And then the ratio between this just load sharing is like defined like that. And then, as I told you, this foundation has a capacity, is a function of the loft and the pile portions, maybe. The previous slide I'm showing, and here. And then, this is the load settlement curves for the pile loft foundation. This is the typical conventional pile foundations. How about this is the one, the shallow foundations in between? Maybe this is the blue color means there is some loft with pile designed for full mobilization of the capacity. Maybe this kind of behavior we can expect from the pile loft foundations over here. Instead of using the conventional one and both the pile and the loft. Maybe in between, maybe we can think about the pile loft foundations. Okay. Probably just it's starting around 1990 in the European country, they are starting this kind of foundations, and about 20 years have passed so far. So maybe there are so many some techniques or some kind of some analytical method available. So there are all the European, the Baninpi is a professor, Randolph is Australian, GARP is a Poulos professor here working the this commercial code they proposed, and just today's you are talking about the Yonsei Pier. Maybe this afternoon you can just think about my program to consider this kind of complex situations for the pile draft foundations. This is the characteristics for the pile foundations. There are so many things for the pile and the soil problems, and their procedures are talking about what is working or not. Just in my case, just I'm saying I can do everything. That's why I'm just making this kind of counting. But anyway, just it's kind of a simplified, approximate computer-based method and more rigorous computer-based method. This is done by three-dimensional analysis, numerically. This is the in-between. There is a simple and approximate solution. However, rigorous computer-based method is already proposed by several just researchers. Maybe this is the commercial code, FEPR, group 6, OBRA proposed GS loft. Well, we are proposing this one. Maybe here, maybe you have known these commercial codes over here to identify the behavior of the pile loft foundation. Okay. I'd like to summarize. There are three ways to solve these problems, maybe. In the designing of the privilege designing stages, there is a simple empirical approaches to solve the five draft foundations proposed by Poulos, Davis, Randolph, three persons, PDR method, and some other methods, so Berland and Banimpi method. It's a preliminary design stages, maybe based on just calculation, simple calculation. And then, as I told you, approximately just in between computer-based analysis method, like GASP is a strip on spring foundation, or plate on spring foundations. Maybe yesterday you explained just lab testings, and maybe that kind of some approximate one, like our just approaches over here, is in between. It looks like simple and approximate method. And then finally, if we want to use more rigorous numerical method of analysis, it's the third step. 1, 2, 3. And then finally, based on this, we can have an economical design of the five draft foundations. Maybe this is information for your initial just understanding. How can you design of the five draft foundations? As I told you, in the initial stages over here, and then detailed analysis thereafter. In the preliminary designing, you can think about some kind of some basic design of foundations, like shape, size, array, material, construction method on here, starting point, and then check the bearing capacity of that foundation. It's okay or not? The most important thing to designing a pile draft foundation, first, we nearly want to calculate the bearing capacity. Why? That's the way we can do the, if the bearing capacity is larger than the allowable one, it's not easy to use the pile draft foundation. That means just only the bearing capacity of the one is less than the allowable bearing capacity. That's why it's very beneficial and efficient to use the pile-up foundation based on this. So this is one of the options we must check, and then going down to the other steps. And finally, we can check the settlement of that, and then calculate the whole kind of designing process and then finish. So maybe this is the flow chart of the designing of the pile draft foundation based on this kind of simple routines, okay? And what I'm saying is just if the bearing capacity is not good, for example, the soil condition is not good condition, maybe pile draft foundation is not a good way to designing. Why? There is some resisting force involved in the pile draft foundation. That's why first you must satisfy the bearing capacity is good enough. And then we can start the designing process of the displacement and the other steps. You can design. How can you just make a load sharing ratio about 0.5, the 75% was resisting by pile, and 25% is lapped. You can think about this portion. Target load sharing ratio is judgment by yourself, right? That's the way you can do. You nearly want to have a designing by the foundation. So in the case, how can you get some kind of some load sharing ratio and the other informations? It's very important. Maybe I can show you in the next slide. But anyway, This is the one. First, you must check, and then this one. The other is a routine, and then finally the settlement checking, and then these steps. Okay, you can do. So this is the general rule of thumb to design of pile draft foundations. In your first stages, you can just think about, okay, the pile can be distributed over the center about this ranges of the raft area. What do you mean? Is a raft area is a, well, AG, somebody is a area. And then you can put the piling over here around this amount of just piling. It's your first trial. And then you must consider the stiffness value, the pile stiffness value, group stiffness value is, looks like equal to the raft. The same just material, maybe you can make the same stiffness values. This one of the, you can try. Then you can design about this amount of load by pile itself. So it's 70% means what's that? And then remaining part is resisted by the raft. So it's your judgment based on your information, and then you can optimal design. It's a general rule. Starting for what? Determine pile length, diameter, time, method. It's kind of all geometry is based on this kind of assumptions, okay? And then checking. Shape, size, array, material, construction method. This kind of thing. Okay, it's another way we can think about. I'd like to have up to here and then I will stop. And then I'd like to have this afternoon class again. So based on this kind of assumption, you can think about, and then you must consider the load settlement behavior of the pile up to load settlement and the load sharing ratio, and then load bearing behavior of individual piles. How the loading is transferred to the just pile and soils. That means load sharing ratio, like same meaning. And then finally, based on this information, we can just calculate the internal forces and the bending moments for the structural designing of the piling and the raft. This is the general steps we must think about, right? Load settlement, load sharing, load bearing, and then the checking of the all the member forces over here. And then consideration of the pile soil raft interactions. Anyway, this is the another one, but this is the general step you can think about. You can check the whole the pile, group pile stiffness. It's almost same as the raft stiffness. I mean, this is a raft, this is a pile. So the individual pile, next, all can, you can check the stiffness value over here. Combining all the stiffness of the each pile, and then make this kind of the raft and the piling looks like the same stiffness. This is better to have this one. And then array the piling at this point, okay? Making a dimension, spacing, and location.
Just previously, whenever we had a pile cap, and the pile cap, unintentionally, it used to be cast on the ground floor, on the soil. And we used to build our superstructure over it.
Yes, yes.
So we used to have that, pile cap. So invariably, we were using pile draft, was it? Without even knowing that we are using pile draft.
Yeah, I knew, but it's prefabricated. Yeah, one we are using for the file cap. Yeah, I knew. But
you knew the capacity that you were using.
I mean, that's why you are doing some BioLoft foundation now. So far, we don't consider any other just resistance by BioLoft. That's only the, even though the in field they are doing BioLoft foundation, in the designing purpose, we are only designing BioLoft foundation instead of BioLoft foundation, right? That's the thing. But in order to have a cost effective and some kind of some efficient of this kind of situation, that's why he really want to change it from the BioLoft foundation to the BioLoft foundations. Sure. Yeah.
Preliminary
outline design in the
initial stage, then that means our shading is also
brief. Yeah, I know. Yeah, that's why it's a little difficult to think about. Yeah, you are right, because I'm just talking over here. This is an influence factor, the designing process of BioLoft foundations. So BioLoft dimension, BioLoft array, all the same. Maybe array means there are so many cases over here. Maybe Dr. Ashishi know this LAPT, somebody is talking about here, array. Same one, somebody is talking like that. It's a different array in the same configuration, but this kind of thing, or loading time, end bearing condition, all kind of things is just affect the result of the analysis. That's why I'm summarizing over here. Your dimension, how many numbers, what's the relative position in a group? It's also affecting. It's uniform loading or distributing, point loading. It's also influencing and interactions, or spacing. All things are influencing on the result of that BioLoft foundation. Yeah. So there are many case studies performed to identify this kind of some effect on this BioLoft foundation. Right?
When load X
First, depending on the situation. Yeah, that's a good question, sir. In most cases, it depending on the deformation of the LAPT. Sometime file resist first and then LAPT then. Sometime LAPT first and file is next. It's depending on the situation. So I cannot say clear, not fixed. In this case, this is a result of the testings, the alpha PR, first 0.3. 0.3 means what? 70% was carried by LAPT, and then 30% is carried by the bile. But due to the construction stage is going, and then it's increasing. That means, what's that? The bile get more just loadings as the loading is increased, right? So this is the result of that one. But something is looks like that. I have this kind of some case history. So that means first, in this case, piling accept most of the part, and then as time goes on, it's reducing. So depending on the situation, maybe you can expect different aspects of some load sharing. But in most cases, in the good condition, first, file is just resisting about 75% maximum. Yeah? And then decreasing. After that, the LAPT is just take over the remaining part. So probably the most of the just cases, file is first, And then left is second, but it's the general rule. I mean.
Is there any value of soil bearing capacity below which only a pile is a better option? Pile raft combination is not a good option. Or maybe it is not a cost effective.
It highly depends on the situation. That's why it's not the way. It's a case, it's okay. Depending on the, what is your concern over here? One case and three case and here. So it's highly depend on the settlement criteria. Depending on here, right? You cannot say exactly what depth is shallow, what depth is raft is okay. It's not the way, because it highly depends on your judgment right here. Depending on the settlement criteria. Okay. In my case, okay. Well, we don't need any, settlement. Maybe in the case we must use this cover, yeah, instead of using this one, right? But in some cases, okay, we can accept a certain amount of settlement, maybe we don't use, we use this one instead of using this one. So only highly depends on the settlement criteria. Changed, reduced.
What would be effect in structural effect? Because there will be high punching effect will be there from pier as well as from pile. So what because of the design are taken for punching?
In case of a pile of foundation, the pile inside over here, depending on the deformation, they are all different, axial force developed. Each pile has different values of some loadings. But conventional analysis, okay, is how much? Is 100? Okay, 10 pile, for each pile is 10. Is it? It's a very simple approximation for the conventional one, but in this case, we don't say punching one, because depending on the deformation, we have a different amount of axial force developed. Each pile has different value of the capacity. So,
again, sir, you are talking about the vertical axial loading only, but in actual, there will be longitudinal as well as transverse moment also, and due to this, the outer piles will be having more forces.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I see. But anyway, I can say, based on this kind of some analysis, maybe we can have a lower bending moment, lower shear force in most cases. So what can I say is we can reduce the raft thickness, the cap thickness. We can reduce, also we can get a smaller diameter of piles, we can just use for these pile foundations, pile raft foundation. That's the way I can say. As I told you, conventional one is based on this criteria. So that's why you must use large diameter. Also, in most cases, we don't allow some kind of settlement. That's why you are using end bearing piles. So deeper and deeper and large dia. So based on some kind of some settlement, we can allow. In the case, maybe we can have some kind of a smaller diameter, and also we can reduce some kind of some end bearing depth, right? That's the advantage using this kind of some foundations. That's the way only I can say this kind of conclusions over there. No, it's a different situation. That's another member post checking process. It's not the way. Just in the stages, most of part, maybe punching is a shear force. just depend on the process, right? So by using this foundation, we can reduce the bending moment and the shear force. That's why we can reduce the punching, right? Right? So I can say just even though the diameter is smaller and smaller, you can rigidly saying just it's make more punching. No, it's not the real story. I mean, I did not bring any just slide, but I have several chance to check out the thickness of that raft. Depending on different size of raft, you can have a different value of bending moment shear force. We can get this kind of data, so many data. That's why I'm saying, due to some roughness of the just raft, you are saying of the rigid base. Maybe in the case, maybe you are right. But I'm talking about its thickness is it's not thick, just it's flexible. In the case, you can reduce the shear force and the bending moment clearly. Okay, anyway, just, maybe your question is okay, but still, we really want to study about this concept, and you can have some evidence from just any other just result already performed. Probably I can show you some kind of some result based on some kind of some testings, and you can check the punching, but punching is decreasing due to some kind of flexible foundation. I mean, it's a flexible foundation, looks like. You mean the what? Between
pile and raft connections. Because it will also affect the pile raft foundation.
Yeah, yeah. Yes. That's right. Maybe that's a typical. Anyway, just you mean the connection between just yeah. That's one of the big issue already we are talking about. That's a fixed and free and restrain. So depending on different just connection, just condition, you have a different behavior. Yeah, that's one of the things just you can think about in the designing of this one. Yes. It's the same as the conventional pile foundation. It's all the same.
We can use some disconnected pile and raft and some connected pile.
Okay, that's one of the story we can talk about. Because to reduce this kind of some member force, maybe you can disconnect the pile, but we can expect another one. Due to some kind, yeah. If we have some governing by some wind, maybe there is unconnected, there is overturning problems we can expect. As an engineer, you must think about both of them. Connection, unconnected. What's the effect or side effect? Okay? That's why we are talking about some kind of connections between just the super and the substructure.
Yeah. Some disconnected and some connected ones.
Oh, okay. Well, that's the one of the options, but it's easy in the construction site, it's easy controlling. He's talking about one pile is connected, one pile is disconnected, one pile is connected. So engineer, you can find out what's it's another quality control problems maybe. That's the ideal. You're talking about the ideal just. In case of all the disconnected, it's okay. There is cases in the earthquake zone, they are using disconnected piles to reduce some horizontal force. All piles are all the disconnected. It's okay. But you are talking about it's connected, unconnected, connected, unconnected, depending on the locations of the pile. So it's not easy control in the real field, okay? Now, this flowchart maybe you can just benefit for your just information. I think there is some way how to handle some total settlement and some different settlement based on the procedures, but it still looks complicated, but it looks like the same as just talking I mentioned about by the Professor Kurobe is talking about But the most important thing is the average settlement and some deferred settlement checking process, depending on different some situations. And then, I'd like to emphasize, I told you this morning, there are three different steps to solving this kind of file draft foundation. One is the preliminary design part, and then in the middle, we have some approximate and some kind of some approximate solutions by some spring models. And I'm just showing the exercise in the lab. And third one is the very rigorous three-dimensional analysis. So I'm just starting the first stage is the preliminary design by hand calculation. This is the one is the equivalent peer method, like there is a group wise file draft, and then they can make this group wise is replaced by a single peer of equivalent diameter, like these dimensions. So group wise can be transported by block, just the dimensions, and then calculate equivalently using the peer method. This is some ideas involved in here, and you can see the text, just the lecture note, and then you can see the main algorithm of this just method. Another one is the equivalent LAPT instead of peer. It's a LAPT. LAPT looks like a it's a LAPT. So same as the lecture yesterday afternoon, the group file, we are using this kind of equivalent to LAPT foundation method to solve some settlement part. So the depth at which the equivalent LAPT is located depends on the nature of the soil profile and the range from 2/3 for friction pile and the ending. The L for the end bearing piles. Ending means the top, just the tip of this foundation. Depending on the end bearing condition, we have some kind of equivalent LAPT analysis to solve these pile LAPT foundations. And this is the very popular one in preliminary designing. It's a PDR method. It's a three different persons name, Poulos, P, D, Davis, R, Randolph, Professor, three persons method to calculate the pile draft foundations by hand calculation based on the assumption, the perfectly rigid or perfectly flexible LAPTs. Also, this method is only just restricted to the linear behavior of the pile LAPT systems. It's an assumption, very strong assumption. Based on this assumption, you can make some simplified hand calculation method for the constructing the overall load settlement curve by hand calculation. So this is the procedure I'm talking about, but it's too complicated, not too complicated, but maybe in your case, it's just it's a digital number. It looks like a simple just cases we are performing. It's looks like a hand calculation by calculation of some stiffness of the pile and LAPT and the combining effect. And here, just I'm emphasizing only this equation, the pile and LAPT. The deformation is a function of some kind of loading on the pile, just top and LAPT. And this is the stiffness value of that, just the systems. And to calculate these systems, maybe we have some other explanations, and maybe you can follow these procedures. And it's not too complicated, but I think you don't. Just think about carefully, maybe. It's just I'm showing. And finally, I can show, for example, by hand calculation, And you can just calculate the portion of the raft and the piles and calculate the total load settlement curves based on just hand calculation. That's the preliminary stage based on very strong assumptions, linear elastic materials, and some kind of a flexible and digital pile caps. That's it. So in this just exercising this afternoon, we can make this kind of just load settlement curves based on some kind of calculations. This is the example case I can show you. This afternoon we are starting from here. The second designing stage is we can think about approximate the computer-based analysis. It's in between the preliminary designing part by hand calculation, and then approximate computer-based analysis, and then very rigorous three-dimensional analysis. So in between, just this kind of computer-based analysis. To calculate this one, this just piling represented by some kind of springs. So spring, just a strip on a spring approach or a plate on spring approach. It's almost same meaning. Like here, it's like a calculation you performed yesterday afternoon. It's the lab testings and same as this one. And so that's why I'm showing just my method over here. Yesterday, you are only talking about this just raft and loading conditions. Today, I'm just including some kind of pilings underneath the raft, and you can calculate again. This is the approximate solution to solve these problems based on computer. Okay, so this is one of the options you can talk about, and I'm just emphasizing this one for your exercise this afternoon. And the third, more rigorous numerical method is just like a three-dimensional full analysis. Maybe it's structural just problems, I mean, but I don't count on this one here. Just studying three-dimensional analysis in rigorously. This is a result I performed by this three-dimensional analysis, but I'm just showing. That's it. So just to calculate the behavior of the pile raft foundation, the preliminary, the hand calculation, and then there is some approximate in the middle, the computer-based analysis, and then three-dimensional analysis. So I'm just talking about the kind of in between spring-based the pile raft analysis called YSPR, Yonsei pile raft. There is a description of the just programs. You can just think about just by explanation. But here, there is a raft. There is some piling. Due to some kind of the applied loading, maybe there is action like rotation and some kinds of tilting or some kind of some flexibility of the foundations. And we can expect this kind of some deformed meshes based on the applied loading. And yesterday we are talking about this kind of problems here. And simple one we are just talking about. And then we can add more spring element for the piles here. So somebody just talking about what's the membrane effect over here. I am just saying most of the cases of our just shell element is looks like a bending behavior plus membrane effect over here. Membrane effect means some kind of degree of friction on the vertical directions over here. Combination of the mandrel plate element plus the membrane effect to make just mat flexibility. I can show you a flash shell element over here. And then to have a real settlement by just loading, we can think about actual displacement profile of the mat foundation, like here. Like here, to simulate the general deflections of the foundation subject to some applied loading. And then Here is the degree of freedom of the shell element we are using for the bending plus the membrane effect over here. And then finally, we called this a flash shell element. Looks like the same as the beam element. Beam element. So you are talking about the membrane means some kind of horizontal rotations over here. This is the effect of the membrane, and then previously plate element plus this one and making this one. So this program, we already installed this kind of actions over there, and then apply this kind of beam column element vertically, horizontally, and the bending moment, and then I connect this just piling up to the just pile cap. We call this a loft based on just the head, soil, springs using these options, and then making this kind of some interaction and problems we are solving. This is the piling, this plate, and so in the connectivity of this just is in interface, we can make a nonlinear analysis of that point using this kind of nonlinear algorithm called Newton-Raphson method to find out the nonlinear behavior of some connectivity between the pile and the loft. It's one of the options we are using in the mathematics. It's a very typical one. It's not too difficult, but we are using this kind of nonlinear steps to calculate the head, the pile head to the loft. There is some kind of boundary conditions over there. And to solve this kind of problems nonlinearly, I'm using this kind of a concept to capture the nonlinear behavior of the foundations. And then finally, we can make these programs like here. So today, to calculate the pile draft problems, just I'm showing this one for your exercise. And you know, this method is just an approximate method between the hand calculation and the rigorous three-dimensional just full analysis in between. So this is the case you are talking about this afternoon. And this is the concept of that this just procedures. And this procedure, I'm just briefly talking about the pile draft and some kind of programs involved in the discussion and just exercise session. So based on these just basic ideas, we are talking about computer lab 2 here. Here. Just you are just showing 2x2 pile groups. The loading is acting on the top of this just pile draft. And there is some kind of soils and uniformly sand. And then, and this is the section view, like here. Maybe you know the dimensions. And then this is the plan view. So 2x2 means what's that? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 files acting on top of the pile, each 100 kilonewton. So total is 400 kilonewton, but it's a section view, and you have a soil property and the dimensions over there. And I'm showing the plan view, and you can calculate, this is another story, and calculate the soil settlement or pile settlement based on this kind of, except this piling, same as the yesterday you are talking about. Only we can increase the element. Yesterday, only 4 different elements over there. And you are talking about more element over there. We put the pile, intersection of pile, 2x2 piles over there. So this is the piling, this is the soil part, this pile. So we can simulate some kind of the pile draft foundations based on this one. So you can study from now on. You need a little more input for the 9 elements for the plate and the soil spring elements underneath the foundation. Also, you need to add more pile, just piling section. So it takes more time compared to yesterday. But anyway, it's repeating, just typing, just exercise, and then it's almost same as the input data. Like here, you can follow this procedure based on directions over there. And finally, the problems I'm showing, and then okay, this is the result of the just analysis based on this just procedure. Maybe you can get a load settlement curve for increasing loading. La 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 la. Maybe you don't need too much, just increment. You can something like that, and you can find this kind of a settlement curve. Also, this separately, one is the this pile settlement of the pile head, and this is the what's that the lapped head, and making combine. Well, anyway, depending on locations, we can calculate the row settlement curve for the each pile, lapped, any other just piling. Oops. Locations, we can do this kind of thing. Today, this is the problems we are just checking now. And only you need to consider the piling part. It's another just story we can talk about. And in program, automatically calculate the soil spring components automatically inside. So this is the installed, you know, just program for the PI curves. There are many PI curves, but in this case we are using the Dr. One's curve over here for the TG, the skin friction part of the soiling, is using by the MacBays, very famous the TG curves already installed. So you don't need to worry about it. You can input the soil property. You can directly making this kind of some functions inside, and then directly connect to the program and learning automatically. Yes. Yeah. That's the piling is located in the intersection of this just nodal point, and the plate is 1, 2, 3, 9. Only this is the we called it. In the computer program, we can divide into several elements of pile. But still, no problem. You can make incremental length. Just you can input from top to down, automatically calculate. So only you can considering here is a duplicating input of this part. And more increase of the plate over there.